Okay, so here we have a blank scene in Daz Studio, and we're going to export some figures, take them over to Blender, and then rig them using Rig-GNS. Right now, we're in the Smart Content pane under the Figures tab. Let's start by loading a Genesis 8 female. Then let's head over to the Wardrobe tab and add some basic clothing to the figure, as well as some hair. Next, let's go up to File, then Export. I already have a folder selected. So now I'll call the file Genesis 8 female. Leave the save as type as Autodex FBX. Press Enter to save and then click Accept. Alright, once that is done, let's go to the Scene pane, right click and delete this figure. Now let's import a different Genesis figure. Let's go with this Genesis 9 figure. Again, let's head over to the Wardrobe pane and add some basic clothing. Now we're going to export this figure using the Diffeomorphic export option. So we first need to save the file by going to File and then Save. And let's call it G9. Press Enter to save and then click Accept. Now with the file saved, we can now go back to File and choose Export to Blender. Now with the same file name, let's click Save and then OK. Alright, so now switching over to Blender, let's delete the default cube. Press N to open up the Properties panel. Select Rig-GNS. We're going to start with the Genesis 8 female, so I'll click this large import button. Navigate to our folder. Select the figure and then click Import Genesis Figure. We can press the period key on the numpad to focus on that. Now we can start rigging the character with the rigging buttons here by clicking Add Meta Rig, then Match Rig, Generate Rig. Wait for that to finish. And finally, let's click Rig Figure, which will take some time. And now we have the Genesis 8 figure fully rigged. Okay. Let's switch the viewport shading to matte cap and then texture. Now let's switch to object mode. Press G, X and 1 to move the Genesis 8 figure to the side to make space in the center for the next figure. Okay, now for the next figure, we're going to use the Diffeomorphic option, which is this Daz setup here. So let's go ahead and click the Easy Import Daz. Select the same folder. Select the Genesis 9 figure and then click Import Daz. Now, without making any changes to the rig, let's go back to the Rig-GNS tab, then click Convert to GNS, then Add Meta Rig, Match Rig, then Generate Rig, and finally Rig Figure. Okay, so now we have both figures rigged, ready for animation. Now let's go back to Object Mode, then press G, X, minus 1 to move the G9 figure to the other side. Now we can collapse the rigging section and expand the Animixer tab. Here in the Animixer tab, we now have three parts. The main Animixer buttons here, then the adjustment section, and then FKIK tab. Now we can bring in some animations into the scene by clicking the import motion button here, with options to import animations from Mixamo, Daz, Rokoko, or Actorcore. Beside the import motion button is the get button, which provides links to the website where we can download some of these animations. Since I often work with Mixamo animations, I'm going to click the Mixamo option, which opens up the Mixamo website. Alright, so let's start by searching for some simple animation. Let's search for running in this search box. Select one of the results. And let's enable the in-place option. Remember to always set the preview character to export before downloading the animation. So now let's go ahead and download the animation. Set the skin option to without skin and then click download. Let's also grab this running slide animation and download that with the same settings. Now that our animations are downloaded, let's go back to Blender, click the import motion menu again, choose Mixamo, navigate to our downloads folder and select the running animation. Then click the import button. Now we have the running skeleton in the scene. Since the G9 figure is currently the active object, clicking the bind button will retarget the animation to the G9 figure. Let's play the animation to see what that looks like. We can always unbind the animation and then select a different figure and then click bind again. So now let's look at some of the new features that was added to Rig-GNS 3.8. In the adjustment section, we have this amplify button. And what this does is, it amplifies or exaggerates the motion of the selected bone. Let's look at how that works by selecting the thigh bone from this list. Let's quickly adjust the view for a better angle. Now, clicking the amplify button and dragging the mouse up, you can see that the legs start to wobble. The wobbling is because we amplified on the z-axis. Now let's cancel that and then switch the axis to x. When I click amplify and drag up, now you can see it exaggerates the swing of the legs. So now we can tune it down for subtle motion or just crank it up for a dramatic effect. Okay, so let's do the same for the shin. Click the amplify button and drag up or down for the required result. So that's what the new amplify button does. The tilt button, on the other hand, allows us to tilt the selected bone on the specified axis. The tilt button has been in previous versions of Rig-GNS, so there's nothing new about that. So let's tilt the thigh bone on the z-axis. You can see how it tilts the bone. So that's what the tilt button does. Another new button that was added is this restore button, and this simply restores any bone we've adjusted back to its original animation. When I click the restore button, the thigh returns back to its original animation. Let's also try that for the shin. Click the restore button, and now you can see the leg animation is back to how it was. Another new button that was added is this mute button. Clicking the mute button simply prevents the animation on the selected bone from showing. You can see the thigh is no longer moving. Let's also select the shin and mute that as well. Now you can see both the thigh and the shin are not being animated. Alright, so now let's unmute the shin as well as the thigh. Okay. Finally, there's the rotate button. But before illustrating what the button does, let's import the second animation we downloaded, the running slide. Import that. So once that is imported, let's select the G9 rig and then click the bind button. Okay, so the rotate button, as it implies, simply rotates the character's rig, making it face a different direction. You can see the character is now facing towards the x-axis while still sliding along the y-axis. Now when we unbind and then click bind again, the rig's orientation returns to normal. Now, with this pin option on the button disabled, clicking the rotate button will now rotate the character around the rig's actual origin, where the root bone is. Now you can see that the character is facing the x-axis as it also slides along the x-axis. Alright, so these are the features added in Rig-GNS 3.8, and I hope they help improve your workflow. If you like the video, don't forget to give it a like, and kindly subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. And if you have any questions, suggestions, or feedback, feel free to drop them in the comments. Thank you for your time. Till next time.